Hey everyone, welcome back for another Dolph Lundgren movie review, and it's you once again. And today, now of course, I'm gonna review Skin Trade, and I have to wait to talk about this film till tomorrow because I just revisited and I've watched it. This is actually the final film for Dolph Lundgren that I own my collection. I don't have all other his films. The only one that I still do have is actually the Expendables trilogy, which I do have, but that's that I'm gonna do for Sunday for Sylvester Stallone marathon. But yeah, this is the final film I do own from Dolph Lundgren. Oh, of course, I forgot Johnny Mnemonic, but that's actually with Keanu Reeves. So yeah, I forgot I have that film with John from him with Keanu Reeves in it too. But Skin Trade, what can I say, came out 2014. It came out the same time as John Wick was released, and that's cool. And Skin Trade is a fantastic action film. Yes, every time I revisit this film, I've watched this film, it's really a fantastic action film, very fantastic shot from 2014. And this is released after John Wick. John Wick was released 19 September 2014, which was premiere in the US. And this movie was in the US in November, 7 November 2014. And I think this movie did came out in movie theaters because it was actually the topic, the human trafficking, more sex, human sex trafficking, but it's actually a topic of human trafficking. And this was the Dolph Lundgren wrote the story. He actually wrote the story when he read it in 2005. He actually in 2005 he read the article in the magazine when he read the news report about a group of girls being smuggled into the US from Mexico. The girls were left in a vehicle along the border and trapped inside. They all died of heat stroke and suffocation. And yeah, it was suffocation at that time when Dolph Lundgren, he had two daughters. He actually very he very simpa he was very sympathetic, and he was very sympathetic to the girls and to the victims. And he said this is a this story has to be told. And he's also stated that it's very important, because I agree with him, it's very important. He said those women, children, they're actually physically humiliated and psychically abused. And he was very sympathetic to the victims. He felt very remorse for the girls, and he wanted to do this movie. And by the way, he wrote it the screenplay before even Taken came out. So it's not a copycat. It's actually 2007 he wrote the screenplay. The story, they actually worked. You know, at one point, Dolph Lundgren wanted to direct this film, but was against it. So he chose other director for the film. And because they have so small writing, Kelly barely can even wrote the from Germany. You know, can barely wrote what's writing. So I had to went and write the direction. Director was Ikechai Ukerungetayam, which I don't know, but Dolph Lundgren chose him because he was impressed with that film, Beautiful Boxer. He was impressed with that film, so he chose him. He also wrote the story. At one point, he wanted John Hames, but he chose this director. He wrote the story with Steven Elder, Gabriel Dovrig, I think was Dovrig. I can barely even read this on the cover. But it was also with John Hames. But while he tried to film this film, he tried to do the story in the Russia, but it did not work. He really tried to do in the Russia, but it did not work. So he decided to choose South Asia. I think one of his friends tell him, so he choose more exotic locations in South Asia. You know, so that this movie was shot in 50 days, in Canada and Thailand. So he choose exotic locations out Asia, which is awesome. This movie was also was very terrible criticized by people, like because it was a topic of human trafficking, or because they were something like they didn't like his fluent English language. I say bullshit. I mean, 5.7 IMDb does not deserve it. I will put this rating more higher. This movie was practical done. It's done for real action sequences. For Dolph Lundgren, I would say one of his best films, in my opinion. Skin Trade is a pure badass film. I recommend it for all the action fans. And as of the cast, beside Dolph Lundgren and Tony Jaa, we have Ron Perlman. He was in Blade 2. He was Alien 4 Resurrection. We also have RoboCop in this movie, Peter Weller. Alex J. Murphy. RoboCop is in this movie. We have Michael J. White. He was in Universal Soldier 1 and 2, which I reviewed both of them. Michael J. White, he was also in Disputed 2, Last Man Standing. We also do have Kerry-Hiroki Tagawa, which Dolph Lundgren and Kerry-Hiroki Tagawa, they both worked in Showdown Little Tokyo and Bridge of Dragons. I reviewed both the films. Like I said, Showdown Little Tokyo is my favorite movie that Dolph Lundgren did. And I think that the rest of the cast were also Celina Jade and Mai DuPont, which were in this film. But it has kind of solid cast. And this movie is really solid done. It's decent, it's solid. It's a really good action movie. I really recommend it. This is a really good action movie. You know, Skin Trade. Two cops, one mission, no mercy. That's translated in German, you know. But Tony Jaa, so long time ago I saw that film. Rick, come here, Rick, I'm calling my dog, Rick. Say hi to the audience, Rick. Yeah, I saw Tony Jaa in Ong Bak. I only saw the first one. Yes, I know there are actually three movies, but I only saw the first one. I only saw the first one, and Tony Jaa is very slick. I mean, his best shape in his life. Like he moves like Jackie Chan. And man, I saw flying knees by Tony Jaa in this movie. He's a very good martial artist. I think he did the last film now this year, and I think he's kind of done. I think he should. I think Tony Jaa should have done more movies, you know. And Skin Trade definitely became one of my favorite action films, you know. For 2014, I can't believe it was the same year released, the same time it was released that we got John Wick. And yeah, there was ne never materialized that there's gonna be a sequel, but I wish that Dolph Lundgren would do a sequel, an explanation that happened to his daughter, you know. And yeah, so like I said, the story talks about human trafficking. Dolph Lundgren plays Nick Cassidy. He's a New Jersey police detective in charge, and he's actually hunting down Victor Dragi. I think it was Victor Dragovic, played by Ron Perlman. He's from Serbia. He's actually the leader of the human trafficking. He's actually trafficking girls, and yeah, he's actually trafficking and he's smuggling girls, and he's selling them to his clients, and he's very rich. And of course Nick Cassidy, who is hunting down Viktor Dragovich for the past few years, his informant and the lead brings into the dogs, which he's planning operation in the shipyard. He's planning with his superior, Captain Costello, played by Peter Weller, to arrest Viktor Dragic and his men, who are actually smuggling girls. And meantime in Thailand, detective Tony Ah, who plays Tony Vitayakul, detective Tony from Thailand, he saves a young girl, gives her money, and he kills the bad guy, but he also gives the information to police in New Jersey, I think it was Newark in New Jersey, which they actually give them information to extradite and arrest Viktor Dragovic. During the shootouts and the in the fights during the shootouts, Nick Cassidy goes and he arrests Victor. He goes and in self-defense, he kills Victor Dragovich's younger son Andrei. He kills him in self-defense, and that really angered Victor, because Victor he goes and he surrenders, and instead Nick killing him, instead that would Nick kill him, he arrests him, but Viktor Dragovic gets on a bail, but because he has a lot of money, his lawyer buys the judge, and he also gets out on a bail. And because Viktor Dragovic and his sons promise blood for blood to take revenge on Nick Cassidy, because he killed their younger brother. His younger brother Andrei, he was just out from college. He didn't do nothing wrong until he shot one of the SWAT team in the leg. And in self-defense, Nick killed him. And we found out that Nick Cassidy, he has a wife, and he has a younger daughter Sophia. And he gets called he gets called by his captain that Viktor Dragovich has been released. And when he sees to the bedroom, there's like they're like Dragovich's men who fire with a rocket launcher, with a rocket launcher. They actually go fire and they destroy his bedroom, and there's a little CGI, but such a practical done. I don't think this movie was CGI either. I did not see any CGI in this movie. Except that explosion, it was little CGI. You can see slow motion, the CGI. And of course, now the brothers of Andrei and the sons of son of Viktor Dragovich, they show up. They actually go and kill Nick Cassidy's wife, but in the fire, Nick thinks that his daughter's also killed, but I think she survives. It's explained by the finale of the film. Nick goes to hospital after 4 weeks recovery. He escapes from he now escapes from a hospital, and he goes on a rampage. He goes to this restaurant and kills all the bad guys. He becomes now vigilante. He's no longer a cop. He now becomes this guy, this guy, the character from The Punisher, Frank Castle. He played Frank Castle in The Punisher 1989. He played Frank Castle. He becomes now Frank Castle, judge, jury, executioner. He goes on a revenge spree in the restaurant, kills the bad guys, and now he goes to Bangkok in Asia. And in the meantime, Michael J. White, he plays FBI agent Reed, but he's actually Korat FBI agent, but we don't know that. And he informs Detective Tony, Vita Yea Cool that Nick Cassidy is now against the law, and that he's crazy, that he's like killing people, and Detective Tony and his best friend and partner, they were assigned to arrest Nick Cassidy. While in the airport, they chased Nick Cassidy, and that time we found out that FBI agent Reed is actually dirty, and he goes and kills the police officer with his own gun, chose the gun to Nick, and he goes and he set up Nick for the other detective's murder. And now Tony gets pissed, and it becomes personal, and he chases through town. He goes and chases Nick through the city, and we see a beautiful stunt scene in which Dolph Lundgren is driving a motorcycle. And this was one of my problems when watching Van Damme's movie, The Order, driving the motorcycle. Like, camera keeps moving with a shaky fucking cam, and was completely a blur. Barely I can see Van Damme driving the damn thing. This movie has no shaky cam. Has no shaky cam. The director was perfectly, Dolph Lundgren wanted to direct this film, but he was against it. And the choice for the director, it was fantastic. I mean, Tony Ah is like on foot, jumping like an ape, No offense, I've been trying to insult apes, but he jumps like a badass, I can see one stunt double. He goes, jumps through the roofs, runs so fast, like a machine in this movie. And he goes, and meantime, Dolph Lundgren perfectly drives a motorcycle. He was also driving motorcycle in The Mechanic, which I forget to mention, but he perfectly drives motorcycle while Detective Tony is right behind him. And there's like, when there's a dead end, Tony doesn't have any bullets. So he stops Dolph Lundgren by trying to escape, and Dolph grabs and throws, and that was really done for real. Dolph Lundgren said that his stunt double was actually resting more. So all the stunts Dolph Lundgren did, all the stunts, the fight scenes are very choreographed, and Dolph Lundgren then escapes. And wait, what then happened? He goes to this house, which he licks all his wounds, he washed all his wounds. He's like all bloody, they're like both bloody. Now Nick, I think that on the next move, the Nick he goes to this club. He goes to this club, and this guy, he's actually probably he's actually raping this poor girl, and he goes, kicks the guy's ass, he stabs him, and he wants to know information, where's actually their sons, where's actually the sons. And they tell him, and the guy tells him where he is, and he goes and he throws the guy, kills the guy, throws him, stabs the guy who tries to shoot him, throws him in the club. And once again, Tony Ah is now right after. Tony Ah is now hunting down Nick once again, and he tells him, "You killed the cop. He was actually my friend." And of course, he says, "I did not kill the cop." He says, "He's my friend. He just had a daughter." They're like they actually go in and fight each other. They go and they fight each other. Which that was awesome. They go and fight each other. The fight scene was fantastic, in my opinion. The fight scene was well choreographed. I mean, watch Tony Ya, he jumps with a knee. I mean, was he training a Muay Thai? Because that was fantastic done. I mean, he was jumping, he uses all those kicks, and even Dolph Lundgren kicks the guy's ass. They both They both kick ass. They kick ass. The fight scene between those two was fantastic choreographed. I mean, this movie is a fantastic movie. It's a fantastic action movie. Well choreographed. Even the fight scene between Michael J. White and Tony Jaa, well, there was no stunt double. I have not seen one stunt double. They did not want stunt doubles, you know. I mean, this movie 5.7 is bullshit. Oh, because it's a topic of human trafficking, it's bullshit in my opinion. I think it's underrated film. 5.7 does not deserve an IMDb. I will put higher than 5.7. And the same is with The Punisher, the same is with Showdown in Tokyo, the same is with I Come in Peace. I mean, those movies supposed to be a classic films, and Dolph Lundgren, in an interview, I Come in Peace, he said it's underrated. I agree. I Come in Peace is underrated. Showdown in Tokyo is underrated. This is underrated films, Kindred. You know, definitely, I'll definitely put this with The Mechanic in my top 5 Dolph Lundgren movies, because it's so great. It's definitely one of his great action films, you know, Skin Trade. And they both go fight each other, and they're like all bloody, there's like all bloody blood squids. And I still love his flying knee kicks by Tony Jaa. I love that. And Dolph Lundgren kicks his ass. Then he grabs the gun, but doesn't kill him. He shoots the fuse. There's like one guy grabs that mat and throws on the Dolph Lundgren's. He throws that mat, and they both go fight each other. The fight scene was fantastic. Dolph Lundgren then escapes, but then he goes. He finds where's actually the ship? You know the. Where is actually, I think the third brother, Jenko, where he's hiding, he actually goes to that shop, you know, with those girls, and he shows up and sees all the girls, you know, he finds all the girls, and he goes and kicks two guys, butt, you know, and he uses AK-47, he uses AK-47, kills the bad guy, you know, he goes and fights off. And that time, Tony Jaa and Michael J. White as FBI agent Reed, they actually shows up, you know, and they're like all shooting the bad guys. And once again, you know, Tony Jaa shows up with his shotgun and tells him, the one you killed was my friend. And Dolph Lundgren tells him, no, it wasn't. It was FBI agent Reed. He shot your friend, he shot the partner, then he showed the gun to me, and he framed me for his murder, and that time Reed shows up and tries to shoot both the men, you know. He also steals, FBI, you know, Agent Reed steals the cell phone from Detective Tony, and he finds the mole. It was actually that girl, played by, Selena Jade. She plays Min. She was sold when she was 12 years old by her mom for $700, and she's actually his girlfriend, and she's her informant, you know, and she's actually Tony's informant. And when Tony goes back in the club, you know, he finds that recording device, and he finds where Dolph Lundgren and Nick Cassidy went, you know. That's how he tracked them down, and he called FBI agent Reed, you know, because he thought they're on both sides. FBI agent Reed, he screwed everyone, because Sidor Dragovic bought him, you know, he paid him. And the fight scene, you know, then we see when Tony Jaa finds out that he was double-crossed by agent Reed, he goes after, he also goes after Agent Reed, he goes to Agent Reed, and there's a fight, great fight scene between those two. There's a great fight scene, well choreographed. Michael J. White was a badass. He blocked every punch, that every kick, every punch that that Tony Jaa did, you know. It, like I said, Tony Jaa was perfectly martial arts, very, he's great. Flying knee kicks, you know, like in Muay Thai, great kicks. I enjoyed the guy so much. Love the fight scene. In the end, he goes and He goes and kicks the guy's butt, you know. He goes and kicks Michael J. White's butt on the end. And now Jango, who tries to escape, you know, he gets shot by his own brother, played by Mike Dupont. He plays Goran Dragovic. He goes and shoots him in the back. And because he says, "You all is fucked up," they hate him, you know. They hate him, they shoot him. And I love that Nick tries to save the guy, the man's life, where did Viktor Dragovic went, you know. And he shoots all the bad guys with AK-47, with his Beretta, you know. He shoots the bad guys with the Beretta, his AK-47 automatic weapon. He shoots all the bad guys, shoots all of them. He tries to save Jenko's life, but Jenko, he tells him there where Viktor Dragovic went. He went actually in Vietnam, in Cambodia, you know. And yeah, and of course, Tony Adams then decides to help Nick, you know. And he goes and shoots Michael J. White in the face with his shotgun. Yeah, Sally. Yeah, with that shotgun, he shoots him, you know. They go now, they now go to Viktor Dragovic compound. And Kerry Hiroyuki Tegawa, he had two scenes in the film, but was sharing no screen time with Dolph Lundgren. But he was friend of Viktor Dragovic, and he let him to stay in his country for two weeks. And when they both find the compound, there's like, you know, Nick uses a rocket launcher and he goes and blows something up, you know. I think he blows the trucks. There's a practical explosion. Great effect, great explosion. You know, he's such a badass with rocket launcher. And Antonia goes and finds Mike Dupont. And I love how he jumped. I love his flying kicks. I love his flying kicks, his jump kicks. I love his flying kicks, his flying knees. He kills Goran Dragovic, and also I love there's a helicopter, and Viktor Dragovic tries to escape with the helicopter, and Dolph Lundgren goes and shoots down with his AK-47 the helicopter. The helicopter falls down, and. And now the both men, you know, Ron Perlman and Dolph Lundgren, they both and fight each other. And Ron Perlman goes and stabs Dolph Lundgren, but tells him that his daughter's alive, he's never gonna find her. And of course, Dolph Lundgren goes and stabs him back and kills him, you know. He kills him. And also, I forgot to mention, when Jango was killed, both the men, they saved all the girls, you know, all the girls they saved. They were heroes in this movie. They saved a lot of girls, you know. And by the finale of the compound, not only that they actually saved Min, she was a hostage, you know, by Viktor. She was a hostage. Yeah, she, they not only saved her. And now, of course, Nick Cassidy decides to find out his daughter that he lost, Sophia, that she was sold, you know. He decides to find her himself because she's still alive, so that was awesome. The movie then, of course, ends with Nick traveling and finding, you know, and of course, Detective Tony and Min decide that they're gonna try to help him if they have any information about his daughter, but that she was sold to the human trafficking. And yeah, there's also not translate. Yeah, there's actually a narration writing that there's so many women, children, you know, they're like 20,000 a year they're actually sold, you know. And that was kind of really done for real, you know. It was done for real. I mean, skin trade is very well done. Great, but best, one of Dolph Lundgren's best performance. Like the motorcycle chase was fantastic, and Tony is on foot. That was done for real. No stunt doubles. Dolph Lundgren said my stunt double was resting. That means there is no stunt doubles. Both the men did not want to have stunt doubles, so they did not use that much stunt doubles. They don't need it. I have not seen one stunt double for those two guys, you know. This is the Blu-ray disc, and I really enjoyed this movie. And came out the same year in November 7 as John Wick, which is awesome, which is cool. The director, e cacciai o Kerun Ktiam, did a good job. He did a good job directing this film. And this movie was budget was raised of $9 million. This was actually, it wasn't that low budget, but it's $9 million. And was what? The budget was, I mean, the worldwide was only $500,000, which in my opinion was really a box office disappointment. They call her more money because he deserves it. I mean, $529 million. You know, I mean, yeah, 500,000, $500,029, only $500,000, only that this movie earned. Did not deserve that only, you know. I was this movie, and I still don't get it why, oh, it's a topic of human trafficking. Oh, Tony Jaa's influent English is terrible. Fuck that! It's nothing wrong with his language. Tony Jaa was perfectly, he did perfectly speak English. He was perfectly well done. I mean, better than none. Better than many of Dolph Lundgren movies, you know. Better than many of the Dolph Lundgren movies that he did. You know, better than Michael Pare, in my opinion. That movie, that guy sucked at being an action hero. He's an asshole. He can't do any good movies, you know. Better than Seagal, who's a fat ass. Yeah, there was a briefly talk about Steven Seagal in this movie, but suddenly this wasn't, you know. Seagal wasn't. Yeah, they wouldn't approach Steven Seagal for this movie. Dolph Lundgren wanted some other actor to be in the role. He wanted a supporting role, but glad he changed his mind. So Dolph Lundgren was in the lead role with Tony Jaa. The men were perfectly. They were. They did not know they were both the same side. They weren't partners in this movie. They didn't even know each other, you know. And Nick Cassidy, he became an outlaw cop. He became a vigilante and outlaw cop because his wife was killed, you know, by Viktor Dragovich and his son. You know, his sons, Viktor Dragovich, ordered a hit. This movie is kind of the Punisher, you know. My favorite is still Thomas Jane's The Punisher 2004. But that was awesome, you know. I think it's raining outside, and by the way, it's night, that's how you see my light. But like I said, I have to talk about this film now. I can't wait till tomorrow because I'm gonna forget things. Like in the docks, we see all those girls who actually suffocated on the ship, and the captain, he gets shot in the head by Viktor Dragovich, you know, and that's what. Dolph Lundgren wanted to do, you know. He wanted. This was before the Taken, so it was not a Taken clone. And just like I reviewed Six Bullets with Van Damme, you know, Van Damme did a human trafficking. So I love these two guys, you know. They were actually both in Universal Soldier. They were both in the Expendables 2. So yes, I love those two guys, you know. They both did a human trafficking. Just Dolph Lundgren did before Van Damme did Six Bullets, or before even Liam Neeson did Taken. So yeah, so that's cool. And he was so sympathetic to the girls, the victims, because he had two daughters. And I understand Dolph. I understand what Dolph tried to do. He perfectly succeeded. And it's a good action movie. And it's not like The Punisher, you know. It's not like The Punisher. You know, and they both save a lot of girls. A lot of girls they save, and I just love that. It has a blood squeeze. It has a great fight scenes, great shootout. Like Dolph Lundgren shoots one of the guys to take him 47, or with his gun. There is a great shootouts. You know, kind of feels like Double Impact. I know Double Impact was filmed in 1991, but feels like Double Impact. Or Out for Justice. I kind of miss those kind of action movies. Those are my action movies that I grew up. But Skin Trade, Fantastic action movie, you know. Fantastische Kampfszene und der beste Action Cast seit The Expendables. And yeah, it's fantastic fight scenes and the best action set since action cast since The Expendables, you know. So the original Expendable, he did this movie skin trade, which is awesome, which is fantastic action movie. Well choreographed, fast paced, only 1 hour 36 minutes long. I love his character that he's from New Jersey. He travels in South Asia, in Bangkok, then till I think he goes from Thailand to Vietnam, Cambodia, you know. And I love the compound, the fight scenes. There are also kids, you know, in the film, which this movie has balls, and the bowman stop shooting so they don't hit the kids. I love that. I mean, Ron Perlman was fantastic. He was a bad guy in Blade 2. He was a bad guy in Alien 4 Resurrection. Ron Perlman's a fantastic bad guy. He chose the character. Michael J. White used the character, FBI agent Reed, because the character was appealing for him. You know, and I love that Michael J. White is in this movie. He did Undisputed 2, but sadly he did not return for Undisputed 3. Which Scott Adkins took over the film. But man, this is like one of the best from 2000 movies, you know. Probably Dolph Lundgren's last good movie. But yeah. I don't know what else to say, but I really like Skin Trade. I really have fun. More I watch, more this movie starts becoming my favorite of the action films. You know, more I watch this film, the fight scenes, there was no CGI in this movie, because that's what I want. I think there was a few CGI scenes in John Wick, but I don't think so. John Wick and Skin Trade were perfectly for 2014, and 5.7 bullshit in my opinion, you know. Anyway, yeah, that's my review on Skin Trade 2014. Released November in the US. Directed by Ikachai Uker-Kuntam, produced and written by Dolph Lundgren, who also was in the lead role. He starred the movie as Detective Nick Cassidy. And yeah, love this movie. By the way, love these two guys. This is how we do an action movie. They should learn from this movie. The Expendables 3 came out the same year. They should learn from this movie. This is how we do the Expendables movie, not the Expendables 3 that sucked dick. Anyway, take care. I'm out. And peace. And have a good night. And I'll see you tomorrow, which I'm gonna review, I think, another Dolph Lundgren film. Anyway, bye.